Hello everyone, welcome to part 77 of SQL for Beginner series. In this video session, I am going to explain on how to use as keyword in SQL statements. So in this video session, I am going to explain how to use as keyword in SQL statements. What is the purpose of using this as keyword in SQL statements? What is the purpose? The purpose of this keyword is to create a new table. Okay, the purpose is to create a new table with the records of an existing table. To create a new table with the records of an existing table, we have to use as keyword. So let me give an example. Let's say there is a table here. Okay, let's say there is a table. The table name is like something like place. Okay. Table name is place, and in this place table there are some existing records like this. Some records are there, some records are available with the proper data. Now I want to create another table, let's say new place table, with the same table records and columns and everything. Okay, I would like to copy this table into a new table. This new place table is not created yet. I am going to create right away. Here, using the as keyword, I can do that. Okay, I can create with the same records. I can create a duplicate copy of this table with a new name. Okay, new table name. I can create the duplicate copy of this place table. So all these records, all these columns of this particular table with a different name, new place, will be created here. This is possible with the help of this as keyword. Okay, if you use this as keyword while creating the table, then we can create a copy of the existing table with the same records. Fine. So let me practically demonstrate how to use as keyword in SQL statements for creating a new table with the records of an existing table. Fine. So here, as you can see, there are few databases. These three databases, Circulasis and World databases, came by default when I have installed and configured MySQL in my machine, and other database QFox has been created by me. So now I would like to work on this world, okay, world database. For that I have to select this database called world. So use world I have to use. Then current selection is QFox. Now I would like to select world. So select this and run this. The world database got selected. Under this world database, okay, since I have selected this world database, I can perform any operations on any of these tables of this world database. Now, as you can see, there are some default tables available here: city and city, country, country language, place. Okay, all these are the default tables. Now there are I have performed some operations, guys. I'm just dropping those tables. Okay, in the previous videos or whatever it is, I have worked on some. These tables are created by me, guys. Whatever the tables I am deleting from here are created by me. I'm just dropping them because I don't want them to have. So drop. So by default, when you have this world database coming from this MySQL, right, by default they will have four tables. Under the world database, you will see city, country, country language and place tables. Okay, so now I would like to work on this place table. Okay, I would like to create a copy of this place table in there by creating a new table. You will see that in action. So the place table is already there. So I would like to find out what are there in that place table. Select star from place, I have to say. If I say that, all the records from all the columns of this place table will be displayed here. Run this. You see, all the records of this place table from all the columns got displayed here. Now I would like to create a new table. Okay, new table, but that table should be the copy of this existing place table. Okay, I am going to create a new table in this world database, and that table is going to have the same details, same records, same columns of this place table. So how to do that? Create table. Okay, create table. What is the table I would like to create? New place. Okay, new place table. New place. Old place, normal, I mean available existing table is place table. Now I'm going to create a new table with the name new place as. Okay, create table new place is as. Select star from place, I have to say. Okay, this is a single statement. Create table new place as keyword. How to create this new table? As this table, that is place table, all the column, all the records from all the columns of the place table should be copied into the new place table while creating the new place. If I run this, okay, before creating the table, if I say select star from new place, the table itself is not there. We'll get an error. Okay, we'll get an error saying that table doesn't exist. This new place table is going to be created. It's not there in the world database. After running this create table new place as select star from place, run this. Now it's creating the table and at same time it's copying all the records columns of the place table. So now if I say select star from new place this time, you see whatever that was there in the place table, that is now there in the new place table. All the columns, all the records. Fine. There is one more thing. Okay. This is how we can use as keyword for while creating the table for copying all the records, all the columns of the existing tables. Fine. Now, the next case I would like to explain is I would like to create another table. Okay. I would like to create another table. Let's say create table place two. Okay. Place two table I would like to create. As this time I don't want to copy all the columns of, okay, all the columns of the place table. I don't want to have here. Place table has three columns: ID, name, district. When I created the new place, I also got the ID, name, district into the new place. But here, place two. For while creating the place two, I don't want this three columns. I only want this name and district to be copied from the original place table. How to do that? Create table place two as select. If I say asterisk here, this will copy all the columns. Okay, all the records from all the columns will be copied from the place table. But here, instead of this, I'm going to specify name comma district. Okay, from place table, from the original place table, I'm only going to copy, while creating this place two table, I'm going to copy only the name and district columns and their data from the place table. From the place table, run this. Before running this, again same thing. Let's follow same thing. Select star from place two table. Okay, the place two table I'm going to create, right? Select star from place two. This table doesn't exist because you have not created it. Now if I run this, create table place two as select name comma district from place, only these two columns should be copied. Okay, not everything. So it has been executed. So if I again run the select star from place two, you see the new table has been created only with two columns, name and district, but all the records came with the data of name and district columns only from the place table to the place two table, that is newly created table. So guys, this is how we have to use as keyword in SQL statements for creating the tables by copying the existing records and columns from the existing table. So that's it guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.